our engine out. So we're actually going to kill an engine. All right.
All right.
So I'm going to fail the left engine with the mixture.
Okay.
And I want you to remember your steps. All right.
All right. You're in control for a while?
Let me all right, my controls. My... Just let me know when you're ready.
Ready. This, I'll use this checklist, though, instead of my emergency.
Is it on there? That's the restart. In-flight engine failure. Yeah. Okay.
All right.
All right.
All right, my controls.
Just remember, the first few items need to be from memory because this happens real quick, okay?
Okay.
All right, but I'm going to fail left engine.
Right rudder, left engine, verify, mixture, prop.
All right, no, prop, there we go.
There we go.
Now what?
Identify.
Fail.
Airspeed.
Mixture, prop, throttle, flaps up.
Gear up.
Gear up. Identify.
Verify.
With the throttle.
The throttle. All right. I put,
no, that's your live engine.
And there's no change in sound on the left, so I killed my left.
There you go.
All right. And then we start to feather.
Okay. Now, troubleshoot first.
All right.
Alright, let's raise the dead a little bit here.
Alright, there we go.
Raise the dead, split the ball. Alright, so go through the troubleshoot checklist.
It's still this one, as your flight, verify, right? Okay.
Troubleshoot.
Airspeed is on.
Alright, look, control your airspeed, control your heading.
Okay. Alright, maintaining that triangle.
Alright, airspeed 88.
Alright.
Alright, don't actually do any of this, just...
Okay.
Just say it's not working.
Copy.
Alright. Just run through all the controls.
Oh, right, is on cross feed. Now we got fuel. All right. Fuel pump. I will turn it on. I will turn it on. Mixture. Is it full rich? Prop. Throttle. Alternator. Alternator's on. Mags are on. And, All right.
So now nothing works, so secure the engine.
All right, one inch secure. Close the ball, verify, fix or feather. So...
Feather.
Feather first, all right.
Yep.
All right. Wow.
And
there we go.
Mixture.
Mixture cutting off.
Alright. Complete yours. Alright, make sure you maintain your airspeed. Alright, we're flying with one engine.
Wow.
Alright, and turn the fuel pump off. And turn the... don't leave the magnetos on. Don't risk turning off the wrong magnetos if you're just doing this as practice, alright?
Roger.
So, and leave the cow flap alone. But normally you would. Okay, so now that we've got an engine kill, maintain 88 knots, we lost about, so our single engine absolute ceiling is gonna be around this much, right?
Right.
All right, so let's just go ahead and do a turn, just a little turn to, 340.
And no more than 5 degrees?
Standard rate's fine.
All right, cool. And keeping the ball split.
All right, and you can see the airplane will fly just fine on one engine, no big deal. All right, let me just do some basic turns. And you can see the C cylinder head temperature is cooling down, that becomes important when we restart the engine. All right, so now we're gonna run through the start engine checklist.
Right. All right, mixture.
Forward.
Forward. Prop is full forward.
All right.
All right. Throttle is a quarter inch. Switch is on, fuel pump on.
Fuel pump on.
Both?
Yeah, just that one.
All right. Fuel pump on, and we start.
Okay. Go ahead. You may have to pitch it down a little bit to help it out. Keep it coming.
Okay.
Start. All right. Restarted. All right, now what does it say? There's a note.
Manifold point pressure until temp is up.
All right, so we keep it at 15 inches of manifold pressure until the cylinder head temperature here comes into the green. Now you can help it out by leaning it a little.
All right.
But until then, leave everything else full. We still got partial power, so again, and we can also help it by decreasing our airspeed a little bit. And client, yeah.
At this point, it's still ideal for me to keep the ball split or just
I mean, you've got power in both engines, so
okay.
It's not as critical.
All right.
I'm gonna close this cowl flap.
And in the
Sugar Land ground, Cessna 2144 Victor, at the flight school with information in Foxtrot, ready to taxi for Southwest Park.
Alright, we're in the green, so we can go ahead and
I got it.
Alright, and we're at 4,500. Good.
Alright. 5-5.
Down to, some altitude. I don't really care, but let's head back to Sugar Land. We'll do
Roger.
We'll do touch and goes.
Yep.
Don't mess with that.
All right, just
clear.
Clear.
Nearest airport. Enter. Not Lane, not New Gulf, not Lackey, Sugarland. Direct, enter. Boom. And set your course. Alright, we do need to descend because the
shelf.
The shelf's at 4,000. So. And we're at 5. So let's get down. And let's see.
Let's get a sauce. Hades.
3042. ILS runway 35 approaching you, sir. I'm going to departing runway 35. But notice to airman runway 35, reels out of service. Miles on the missed contact, jam information, Foxtrot. Alright. Sugar Land Tower information, Foxtrot, time 18530 weather. Wind is calm, visibility 10. Sky clear, but we're going to be 3042. ILS runway 35 approaching you, sir. I'm going to departing runway 35. Notice to airman number 5, reels out of service. Miles on the
yeah. Now well, we're gonna go back anyway. Right. Cool.
Academy Ops, 6030 November, 4300 east of the lake still.
Alright. Whenever you're ready.
Sounds good,
Sugarland Tower, Seminole Niner.
On tower.
Oh.
Now you are.
Sorry. Alright. Seminole, Sugarland Tower, Seminole Niner 4 Charlie, 11 miles to the west southwest, inbound for touch and go, Swiss Foxtrot.
Seminole Niner 4 Charlie, Sugarland Tower, report 2 mile left base, runway 35.
4 2 mile left base, runway 35, Seminole Niner 4 Charlie. Power as required, mixture rich. Fuels are on. RPed as required. Both closed. ADIS has been got. Altimeter set. Fuel pump off, yep.
And we'll turn it back on in a minute, but.
Right. Level off at like 2000,
but get back on course. You see the airport yet?
I see the white hangars there.
Yeah.
The end, right.
Okay, so we need to be on a left base for 35.
Yep.
So.
Anyway, this is good already. It gives us enough time, right?
Yeah. Yeah. I like a modified. Go a little bit closer.
Okay. Parallel, all right.
This is 59, right?
All right. Riding light on, autopilot is off. Drop sync, no, we don't got. Yes. 4 miles to go.
Sugarland Tower, Cessna 2144 Victor, holding short at 35, ready for departure to the southwest.
The 2144 Victor, Sugarland Tower, left turn out approved, runway 35, cleared for takeoff.
Cleared for takeoff.
Coming left down with approved. The gear.
2144 Victor.
Undercarriage. One mile to go. Sugarland Tower, Seminole 94 Charlie's on 2 mile left base, runway 35.
Seminole 94 Charlie, runway 35, clear touch and go, right close traffic approved.
35, clear touch and go, right close traffic approved. Seminole 94 Charlie. Oh, forgot. Flaps down, sorry. Flaps down, full throttle.
Not yet. We got to go all the way up to 1500, remember?
1500 pattern, right? Okay. Batting light.
Leave it on.
All right.
Going 44 Victor, frequency change approved.
Frequency change approved, 2144 Victor, thank you.
Alright, 1,500.
Roger.
Go ahead, turn downwind. We don't need to be quite this wide.
Roger.
go through your checks.
Alright. Be it.
Continue flying the airplane. Mixture, prop.
Mixture, prop.
Throttle.
Throttle, forward.
Flaps up, gear up.
Flaps up and gear is up.
Identify.
Three Towers is 857,
identify.
Holding short runway 35 for closed traffic with Foxtrot.
Verify, right engine.
Alright,
no time to troubleshoot.
Tower, right closed traffic approved.
No time to troubleshoot. You just, feather
right
and mixture.
Right traffic approved, runway 35.
Feather and mixture.
Sugarland Tower Seminole 2094 Charlie midfield, right downwind 35, touch and go.
2094 Charlie, runway 35, clear touch and go.
Clear touch and go, Seminole 94 Charlie, 35.
Alright, so we have to manage this, we have to manage this.
Alright, energy, alright.
Alright, so start your descent. You don't have to fly a pattern, or you don't have to square it off, so just start reducing the engine. And go ahead and bring the gear down.
Roger.
Alright. Just manage the power, just a nice, gentle turn. Keep turning, keep turning. May want to increase that engine power a little bit. Alright, just keep turning. Alright, so now we can think about adding some flaps.
Alright.
So we're below 111, so just add two notches. And you can reduce power on the engine there. And just bring it on in. You can probably, we have plenty of runway. So remember 100 knots and just use the engine. Alright. You can bring it to idle, and you've got, we made the runway, so put in your last notch flaps if you like.
Roger.
And then still use your good engine if you want to.
Do make corrections before we touch.
Right, but once you touch down, or if you need to go around, you have both engines. Alright. Oh, this here, just kill the engine, and just, you can just flare it all the way down. Just like that.
All right, flaps coming down.
All right.
Beautiful. How are you, civil runway?
Alright, let's
This is 7 Charlie Papa, runway 35, clear touch and go.
Bring on home?
Yeah.
Alright.
35, clear touch and go.
Sugarland Tower, Seminole 94 Charlie, this will be a full stop.
Seminole 94 Charlie, there's traffic ahead of you on the downwind. Just about to turn a right base, it's a Cessna. Your number 2, runway 35, clear to land.
Clear land, runway 35, following the Cessna, and I got a visual.
Alright, maintain pattern altitude until you're ready to descend.
Crouch.
At about 20 inches. That'll get you a good pattern speed. Right?
Okay. Three green. We got gas. Undercarriage. Green. Mixture. Prop. Safety belts. Circuit breakers are all in. Heading light on.
Alright, start descending. And flaps.
Below 111.
Still a little too high.
Yeah.
Probably could have just waited a little bit longer.
Alright.
But yeah.
Descent rate.
Yeah, you got a good descent rate though, so. Yeah, you're fine. Today.
Not today, sorry, I've blown past Charlie 2. I added a little bit of extra power there.
You could have reduced it to idle a lot sooner than
yep,
when you
I
did.
I know.
7094 Charlie, turn right at Delta, taxi to Anson, and monitor ground 121.4.
Right Delta, and on to Anson's, monitor ground 121.4. Seminole 94 Charlie.
Alright, and after landing checklist, don't forget.
Watch.
And don't taxi too fast.
Flaps up, carpet off. Bow flaps are open. Fuel pumps coming up. Ropes off. I'll keep. Landing light off.
The landing light on.
Landing light off.
Because it's also the taxi light.
Alright. Heat is still.
Leave that on altitude reporting.
All right.
Let's keep going. All right, remember, not too fast.
taxi behind, right?
Yep.
Chevrolet ground.
He's going to the fuel pump.
Mike Alpha.
So we'll just hang out, let him get there.
Construct departing to Southwest, runway 35.
Shark 928, Mike Alpha, Sugarland ground, runway 35, taxi via Charlie 2, Foxtrot.
Runway 35, via Charlie 2, Foxtrot, 8, Mike Alpha.
Diamond trying to start up. Alright, we've got 8 Mike Alpha over there. He's going out. So he'll
let's
go.
Let's wait for him.
Hey, he's.
And
yeah.
He's going to go anyway and go. He'll be clear by the time we turn.
Yeah. He'll go ahead, swing it around. Swing it around to the next row. And watch out for this guy. He's not in a parking spot. He's okay. Just sitting there.
And this little, one? We'll stop here?
No, keep going.
Okay.
We're gonna put it next to that arrow, 1473 Tango.
Alright.
Alright, so turn right. Alright, so, no.
Oh, we're going to swing forward in order to push back?
Yep.
Alright.
Chief flight instructor doesn't like us taxiing over the tie downs.
Roger.
So keep going forward.
Okay.
Angle a little bit to the left, and then we got nobody in here so we don't have to worry about them, but keep going forward, forward, and right now cut it to the right and line it up with that 150 over there. That'll let us pull it straight, push it straight back. All right, let's shut this engine down.
All right.
Yo, here, I'll help you out.
Avionics off.